Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. All right, so I originally attempted to do this video out at the beach and the wind was popping, but it was a beautiful day, so I still inserted this video that I got from that trip. But anyway, let's get into the intro. So this video reading is Who's Been Spying on You? And you got three options to choose from. You can see the options right here. But before I get into further which option is which, I'd like to thank all of you who are subs to this channel thus far. Thank you, thank you, thank you. If you're brand new, I want you to hit the sub button as well as the bell notification. I drop videos weekly. Also, thank you to all of my patrons. If you're interested in becoming a patron of mine, then check that pinned comment below as well as the description box below. Follow me on my other YouTube channels. Pinned comment below as well as the description box below. And yes, all of you all who keep me booked and busy, I love you and I thank you and I'm forever grateful. If you're interested in a private reading, coaching, sanity rewalk, and re-priority reading, I want you to check that pinned comment below as well as the description box below. And lastly, I'll be in Atlanta May 21st, 2022. Yeah, you all are already filling out that form. So yeah, and we're still a month away. Slots are still available. I want to meet you all. This is a timeless read, but Atlanta, May 21st, 2022, I'll be out there. I'm on this meet and greet, y'all. So three options to choose from. Keep in mind, these are general messages. Everything's not going to resonate. Take what resonates. Leave behind what doesn't. All in all, I want you all to vibe out to this reading. When you're ready, come to the reading. We're about to start it now. So who's been spying on you? Who's keeping tabs and why, and do they have anything to say? We're gonna do tarot and we're gonna pull some initials. All right, y'all. All right, so option number one, those of you who chose the first stone, let us find out who's been spying on you, who's been keeping tabs and why. Universe, thank you for the channel messages. Spirit guides and ancestors of those who chose option number one. Who's been spying on option number one? Who's been spying on option number one and keeping tabs? We have the Eight of Wands that came out in the upright. This could be somebody who is at a distance from you. This could be somebody that you had a very intimate relationship with, maybe a very highly sexual relationship, lustful relationship. This could signify people that are at a distance, or you have a lot of people in regards to like social media watching. With this Eight of Wands, we have the King of Pentacles, earth sign energy, so Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Somebody with, I feel like definitely this is somebody who's a big spender with this King of Pentacles. So somebody with maybe, you know, pretty large means in regards to, you know, money, resources, that type of thing. We have the Page of Pentacles in reverse. So this could be somebody that you dated, but this person didn't really offer you a connection. Look, Seven of Pentacles in reverse. Somebody that you dated but did not really offer you connection. Definitely feeling heavy on the earth sign vibes. So it feels, honestly, option number one, this is feeling like somebody you might have had a situationship with. Or maybe a friends with benefit type of situation. This is somebody maybe you found yourself like really, you know, wrapped into at one point in time. Somebody who talked a good game. Somebody who's a big spender. Somebody who's at a distance from you. But ultimately, someone that the relationship did not fully materialize with. We have the Strength card in the upright. So this person could be a Leo. This person can have their own business. That's what I'm going to with that Strength card to. CEO, somebody who's very confident. Who else? Who is this person keeping tabs on option number one and why? Who is this person keeping tabs on option number one and why? We got the Queen of Swords. You could have met this person at work, or maybe met this person at some type of school, instructional certification type thing. Hermit card came out. So Virgo, you have a Virgo that is keeping tabs on you. Yeah, somebody's at a distance with that Six of Swords in reverse, but they want to come back towards you. So let's find out, why is this person keeping tabs on option number one? Why is this person keeping tabs on option number one? Tell me, why is this person keeping tabs on option number one, universe? Give me two cards. Why is this person keeping tabs on option number one. Two cards, why is this person keeping tabs on option number one? Why are they spying on option number one? Why is this person keeping tabs on option number one? All right, Six of Wands in the reverse. So definitely this person's watching you over social media, but when incognito mode from a secret account. We have the Hangman that came out in the upright. This Hangman definitely wants to come out. So definitely somebody who misses you. This person's keeping tabs on you because they miss you. This is somebody who would like to reach out to you, but the Hangman energy is like they stop because they don't know how you're going to regard them. Option number one, if you're going to answer the phone, if you're going to pick up. Give me one more. Why is this person keeping tabs on option number one? Four of Wands, they miss you. Now, here's the deal. This may be somebody who did not offer you a connection or a commitment in the past, but this is somebody who's thinking about commitment with you now. Definitely, this is somebody who maybe the grass wasn't greener on the other side, or they let you go. They lived some life and they realized that, you know, hey, I really had a good thing going with option number one. So definitely, I feel like this is a romantic connection, or this could even be a friend that walked away from you. All in all, this person walked away from you. This feels like a connection of where you were denied something, you know, they denied you of something pivotal, like this connection. It may have been a few years in between you and this person. That's what I'm getting with that one. So maybe at least 3 years between the last like romantic interaction, or since the last time of you all's relationship. That's what I'm getting with that one. Give me more. Why is this person keeping tabs on option number one? Why is this person keeping tabs on option number one? Devil card. Ooh, look at that. And this one flipped. Definite earth sign. We got the Capricorn that popped out. This person's missing sex with you. They're missing your body. They're missing interaction with you. Option number one. This person's really missing interaction with you. And it's going a lot deeper, though. It's like you've been on their mind a lot. They might have even been seeing signs of you. But it's going a little bit deeper because this is somebody who, you know, if they could come back in this regards, commitment, romance, they'd head back towards you. Page of Wands. This person's been fantasizing about you a lot. You've been on their mind. So I do feel like currently this person is single, because I do feel like at one point in time when this person left, it definitely could have been because of another connection. Definitely something separated, not just in distance, but maybe, a third party situation had came into play. At current, this person is single. They could be watching you glow up. They're watching you look good. And this person, they want that good thing back. Let's see. So let's find out more. What does this person want to say to you? Will they say something to you? Because this person wants to say something to you. What does this person want to say to option number one? And will they come forth? What does this person want to say to option number one? And will they come forth? We have the Ten of Swords in the upright. And we have the Ten of Wands in the reverse. Interesting. Let's see. What does this person want to say? So for the most part, this person did let this connection go with this Ten of Swords. Like it was a done deal. This is a complete cycle between the two of you all. I really do feel like this person had moved completely on. Even with the Ten of Wands, like they weren't even carrying the burdens of this relationship anymore. So they had moved completely on. But the Emperor card in the upright, you know, this person definitely was the controlling one in this connection. They wanted things on their terms with the Emperor card. This person, I feel like they want to say something to you, but there's the restriction of the Emperor card. It's almost like this person's pride, strength right here is in the way. So this person be a fire sign. We got two fire signs represented that popped out, but hella earth. I promise you this person's an earth sign. I definitely feel like they're thinking about you, they're fantasizing, but at the same time, they stop themselves because there's a lot of pride. They feel like you're going to reject them and them coming back forward. And we got the Knight of Cups. So this person definitely, I do feel like this person may want to take you out, or some type of romantic interaction, you know, some type of coming back together. This person could be heading back towards your area or towards you. So let's see, will this person come forth and speak to option number one? Will this person come back forth and speak to option number one? How soon, if so? We got the Ace of Pentacles in the reverse. Got the Wheel of Fortune in the upright. Ooh, interesting. You got the Nine of Cups in the upright. We got the Magician card. This person's coming towards you, Four of Pentacles. Feels like it could be still some time away when this person comes towards you with the Wheel of Fortune and the Ace of Pentacles in the reverse. This very much so can be some time frame up to a year even for some of you. And I know some of you heard me like, what? It's just that this is so much time that's passed between you and this person, option number one, that they don't think that you are interested even. Nearest time frame, I'm hearing the number four. So we're going to be talking about within four months to within a year's time. So about 4 to 9 months. It definitely feels more so like four. But for some of you, it could be off longer because there's been a lot of time that's passed between you two since seeing one another. So this person kind of feeling like, you know, they don't think you're interested in whatsoever. So let's find out. Watch your ears, everybody. Let's get some letter charms to see who this person may be. Now, you all may see initials, or you might see the initials of somebody, you know, that this person is related to. All in all, even if you don't see their name, if the reading is resonating, then it's still for you. All right, so we got the letter H that came out. We got the letter U. We got the letter V. I'm hearing the word hustle. This person hustles a lot. They can have more than one job. We have the letter S. We have the letter S again. We have the letter L. We have the letter L again. We have the letter E. We just need an O, and we got love. We got the letter A. We got the letter I. We got the letter I again. We have the letter U. We got the letter E again. We have the letter N. We have the letter S again. T. And then U. Another you. So that's what I have for you, option number one. You all let me know how you felt about this in the comment section below. How did this reading resonate for you? Did this reading resonate for you? If you would like to book a private reading, coaching, same day read, walk and read, priority reading, I want you all to check that pinned comment below as well as the description box below. Join me on the Atlanta branch of the Meet and Greets, May 21, 2022. I'll be in the ATL. We already got people signing up, y'all. Can't wait to meet you. What else? I said if you want to book a reading and all that, go follow me on my other YouTube channel. And yeah, Patreon. Pin comment below as well as the description box below. And let's get into it with our second option, option number two. Pull these down just a little bit. All right. So option number two, let's find out who's been spying on you, who's keeping tabs. You're gonna find out why and then what they wanna say. So who's been spying on option number one? Option number two, who's been keeping tabs? Who's been keeping tabs? We have the Knight of Cups that came out in the upright. Who's been spying on option number two? Yeah, the ten, oh. Option number two, this could be somebody that you are currently involved with this Knight of Cups. You're currently involved with this person. You might be currently in a relationship with this person. Now, here's the thing. They could be keeping tabs on you because they may not trust you at this moment. Maybe, look, they're feeling conflicted, Five of Wands. They may not trust you at this moment. Or Knight of Cups, somebody who definitely... you all had a situation, you could be in separation right now, or you could have just had an argument. But to be honest, I don't really feel like you all are in deep separation. We have the Hermit card. This person may check on your social media a lot. For a lot of you, I feel like this is somebody that lives with you. For others of you, this may not even be romance. This could be a family member that checks on you a lot. They may live with you. But something about checking your computer, checking your phone. So it's not just checking you on social media. This is somebody that's close to you and they have access to your devices, checking your computer, checking your phone. We got Virgo that came out. We got water sign energy that is really repping heavy. So that's Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. Give me more information, universe. Option number two. Who's been spying on option number two? And why? Give me two cards. You got the King of Wands. Aries energy with that King of Wands is popping out. But this is an Aries. This is somebody you're currently not, I'm hearing you're not having sex with right now. That's spying on you. This could be somebody who recently, you know, when you were together with this person, was picking up your phone, watching your phone, looking at your phone, trying to find stuff. While you weren't looking, trying to see what's going on with your life, trying to figure out this person, you know, can't put their finger on you, but it's like, I know you up to something. Give me more information about option number. Everything is fine. This could be somebody that you've broken up with or on the verge of breaking up with. Definitely somebody who mistrusts you. And definitely something with the phone. This person is watching you physically through your phone. They have access to your phone. Or when they're around you, they have access to your phone. Give me more information. Who's watching? Who's spying on option number two and why? Yeah, the Lover's card. Definitely. Yeah, somebody that you're romantically involved with. You could be dating other people too. Option number two. Or they're dating other people. But it's somebody that you're romantically involved with and they have physical access to your phone. So they're more so watching. Now this person also could be watching you through social media, but in addition to, this person has access to actually like your phone or your laptop. Give me more information, universe. More information. Who's spying on option number two? We got the Page of Swords in the reverse. Yeah, the Page of Wands that came out in the reverse. We have the Three of Wands. This person could be at a distance. This person could be younger than you. This person, I don't necessarily think they follow you on social media, but they know your social media. Now, this person may not have social media themselves because this is the thing. It's like they can watch you, but they also can. They can and can't see you with this Page of Swords. Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, this is somebody that you're currently involved with or most recently had an involvement with that's spying on you. Romantic person. Could be a Gemini. A romantic person. And they're doing it because they don't trust you. Now, this could even be somebody that denied you recently. Like, you know, we ain't got no relationship. You know, like that type of thing. But at the same time, there's some jealousy here that I'm seeing. They do watch you. There's some insecurity in this connection. So let's see, why is this person watching option number two? What do they want? Why is this person spying and keeping? Because they're spying and keeping tabs on you. They're doing both. Why is this person watching option number two, universe? What's going on? Ooh. We got the World card. This person is not done with you. We got the Two of Pentacles. This person could be trying to juggle you and, I don't want to say you in another situation, but it's like they're trying to keep tabs on you to see, okay, what's going on over there. Because this person may have the inkling that there's other people involved, but they don't know. And it could be because this person has other people involved. So it's like, if I'm doing this, then you got to be doing that. Give me more information, universe, for those who chose option number. Why does this person keep the tabs? Seven of Cups. Oh, I just heard Georgie Porgy. All right, here's the deal. This person may be caught up in their feelings about you, option number two. And they're trying to balance things out. This person could even be actively pushing you away, option number two. But I just heard Georgie Porgy. You know the song. I'm not the only one that holds you. Never ever should have told you you're my only girl. Go look that up. I don't know who did the original, but there's a Eric Benet and Faith Evans version. Go look that up. Now, this person may have told you, you know, or you might be under the impression that this person is out here doing a thing, you know, just a hot commodity, just a bim bam, boop, all of that, right? But what this person, and now this person, don't get me wrong, now this person could be out here like legit dating and just all that, you know, or whatever y'all situation is. Now, I'm not seeing a necessarily, for some of you, y'all may be on a break, because there could be a solid relationship here, but y'all on a break, right? But what I'm seeing a lot of right here is this person sees you as their main, their number one option, what they want in their heart of hearts. But there's something here where it's like, but we can't do this. So for some of you, this person already have somebody and then boom, you know, and they feeling away. And it's like they got to check themselves because they starting to feel jealous. And it's like, wait, I can't even have you like that, but I'm feeling jealous. So that's what I'm getting with that one. Georgie Porgy. This person don't want you to know that you're their main and really only true option, the one that they truly want. So they're trying to like balance out their own emotions while still keeping a check on you to kind of see, like, you know, it's like they may be trying to release you, but they don't want you to get away from them in regards to, because you moved on in those regards. It's like, it's okay if I release you and I let you go, but don't go moving on for me, you know? So Seven of Swords. They're trying to see if they can catch you up. Eight of Wands. There's a lot of lust and passion in this connection, but they're trying to see if they can catch you up. That's what I'm getting with that one. So let's see. What does this person want to say to you? Does this person want to say anything to option number two? If so, what does this person want to say to option number two? Does this person want to say anything to option number two? We got the Sun card in the upright. This person wants a happily ever after with you. In some sort of fashion. What does this person want to say to option number two? Six of Swords in reverse. See? If this person has been pushing you away, they don't want it. Best case scenario is this Sun card right here between the two of you all. Then we got the Queen of Swords. And look, Two of Cups. This person wants you. They want a relationship with you. They want a happily ever after. But this person and this connection is still underdeveloped. There's, you know, there's a lot that this person can't give to this connection right now. So this person's trying to push you away, but they don't want to push you away. That's what I'm saying. And even in the sense of, you know, this person is like a friend. They feel like a friend. You know, like they don't want to push you out their life. But yeah, this page is always energy of the prelude to something, meaning it's not ready yet. This person just ain't ready yet. A lot of stuff could be going on, and there's other energies here, but you're that main energy, and you're the energy that they want this thing in their heart of hearts to pop the most. That's what I'm getting with that. So let's get some letters. Watch your ears. I'm not the only one that holds you. Never should have ever told you. You're my only girl. All right, so we got the letter D. Now, even if you don't see any letters represented, that don't mean this reading ain't for you. But yeah, we got D, we got T, we got E, we got F. Ooh, I was hearing this too. DTF. Down to, we got E, we got G, we got N. We got O, we got F, we got R, ooh, Ferg, shout out to all the Fergs out there, we got Q, we got E again, we got E, somebody name could be Eric, we got V, we got Z, we got C, we got I. We got a blank space. This person's mind go blank when they think about you. We got an A. We got a W. We got N. We got N again. We got E again. Y'all, I promise you, when I got these little Scrabble letters, I've never seen so many E's in my life. It's like, where are all the other 25? I think it's like two Y's or something like that. It's like one letter in the alphabet where it's like barely any of them. Ooh, we got Zach, as in Zac Efron. Zac Efron been spying on y'all. Wait, can we spell Efron? I think we can. Yes, we can. Y'all, Zac Efron. Those who know, you know. You know I'm in love with that man. B, T, and we got another E. All right, so that's what I have for you all who chose option number 2. So let me know in the comment section below, how did this reading resonate for you? Did this reading resonate for you? Do you know who this is? If you'd like to book a private reading, coaching, same day read, walk and read, priority reading, join me on Patreon or follow any of my other YouTube channels. Check that pinned comment below as well as the description box below. And ATL, May 21, 2022. So May 21st, 2022, I will be out there for that branch of my meet and greets. And you all come out wherever you are. I am so excited and I am ready to meet you. All right, let's get into our last option, last but not least, option number 3. Who's been spying on you? Who's been keeping tabs? So those who chose option number 3, who's been spying on option number 3? Who's been keeping tabs? Give me 2 cards. Who's been spying on option number 3? Who's been keeping tabs? Ancestors and spirit guides on option number 3. No, I'm not feeling that one. Who's been spying on option number 3? Who's been keeping tabs? Page of Pentacles, somebody that's younger than you may be a bit scattered in energy. This person, not diagnosing nobody, but this person may have like ADHD or something like that. Person's very energetic. Who's been spying on option number 3? Who's been keeping tabs? Who's been spying on option number 3? Who's been keeping tabs? 5 of Wands in reverse. I don't think you're very close to this person. This could be an old friend from childhood, even, you know, younger than you. But I don't feel like you all are keeping in contact like that. Like I said, this person's kind of scattered, kind of all over the place. Who's been spying on option number 3? Who's been keeping tabs? Ooh, definitely spying via social media. You and this person aren't close anymore. This person sees you a lot. Who's been spying on option number 3? Who's been keeping tabs? Look, this 6 of Swords in reverse has been the people that want to come back to you all. This 6 of Swords in reverse has been coming out throughout the entire reading. People who want to come back and in the now, Temperance in reverse. This person can be a Sagittarius. Yeah, definitely this person feels like an associate, like an old friend, possibly an old romantic interest, but an associate, you know, like somebody you didn't have much. You left a big impression on them, option number 3, but they didn't leave the biggest of impressions on you. Look, 2 of Cups in reverse, a romance that didn't go right, something that was real short-lived. I mean, it was not long-term at all. Yeah, that's what I'm getting with that. It was short-lived. So give me more information. Why is this person keeping tabs on option number 3? Let's find out. Why are they keeping tabs on you? Definitely somebody from the past. You're not that close to them. A little bit younger than you. Y'all maybe used to party a lot. Or this was like just a kick it type of situation. Like, it wasn't deep. It wasn't serious. But you left a lasting impression on them. Or they really, you know, clung to you. But it wasn't that deep for you. Like, and it wasn't really that deep in general, but this person just hasn't let go. Give me more information, universe. Why is this person keeping tabs on option number 3? Why are they keeping tabs on option number 3? What do they want? A new beginning. Look at that. You could have had this person blocked. They could have blocked you. Something going on with WhatsApp. This person could have had this person number may not be in your phone anymore. That's what I'm getting with that. But they want a new beginning. That's what this is. That's why they're keeping tabs. King of Swords in reverse. You're not talking to this person. Is this person an air sign? I don't really know if this person an air sign, though. I'm actually feeling this person can be any of the signs, to be honest. That's what this feels like. King of Cups in reverse. Yeah, y'all. I just heard Drew Hill, we ain't making love no more. Yeah, y'all not together no more. Y'all don't even got a thing no more. Look at all these cards coming out in reverse. This Emperor keep coming out in reverse. This person has a jealous streak like none other. Younger than you or bratty, or they are very immature. That's what I'm getting with that. This person wants a new beginning. Page of Pentacles in the upright, Ten of Swords in reverse. They want a new beginning with you. Three of Pentacles, but lives at a distance. Person's far away. They want a new beginning of some sort, or there's some type of distance. That's what I'm getting with that. That's why they're keeping tabs. They miss you, but they want a new beginning with you. So this definitely could be somebody who might be reaching out to you. And it might kind of shock you, like, whoa, I didn't expect that. So let's see. Why don't they want a new beginning with you? Because I feel like this is somebody who may have broken up with somebody recently. And they, who knows? They might be looking at wounds. But let's see. Why does this person want a new beginning with option number three? Why does this person want a new beginning with option number three? What's going on? Why do they want a new beginning? What's their true motive? Seven of Pentacles in the upright. What's the true motive? Why do they want a new beginning? Ace of Pentacles in reverse. This person never really got over you, and they are freshly out of a relationship. Why does this person want a new beginning with you? It's like they were able to put you off to the side when they got into a relationship with somebody else, but now that they're not in a relationship, they're thinking about you. Knight of Swords, they want to rush in and say XYZ ABC, but they're not. Or this person still may be kind of, you know, angry or defensive with that Knight of Swords. Yeah, this is somebody you had maybe predominantly a sexual or just a kick it type of relationship with, and it, yeah. But they're not going to rush in, but they want this new beginning with you. Because it's almost like I saw what it was on the other side, and now I want you in my forever. I want this family. But, yeah, what I tell you, this person just got out of something. Nine of Wands. Just got out of something. Battered and bruised, and now it's like, I wonder if I can get that back. But something about your energy feels extremely moved on. Option number three. Like I said, this feels like something where, ooh, for you, it wasn't as deep as it is for this person. That's what I'm getting. They definitely clung deeper than you did. And you might even be saying to yourself, like thinking to yourself, I know that ain't so-and-so. It wasn't even like that. That's what I'm getting with this one. So let's see. Will this person end up saying something to you? Because this person may be staying away too, because it's like they know you were pushing them off. But let's see. Will this person say something to option number three and when? Will this person say something to option number three and when? Will this person say something? Option number three and when? What's their message for option number three? Will this say something to option number three and when? King of Wands in reverse, Five of Pentacles in the upright, Ace of Wands in the upright. Will this person say something to option number three? When? I don't want that many cards. Will this person say something? Four of Pentacles in a reverse. Hangman. They're going to say something to you. Wheel of Fortune, the upright. They're going to take action. They're going to say something to you. This person's coming towards you within 5 weeks. That's what I'm getting with that one. Within 5 weeks, they're going to pop up. But I don't know. Your energy, it don't seem like it's going to turn out for them in the way that they hope. Because I don't see you, like, really rushing back in. I don't see you really being into this person. So it's not going to be the same for them, for you, that it is going to be for them. They're going to try to have sex with you. With this, they're going to try to, you know, seduce you of some sort. And you might, you know, you might get your little thing off. But I don't feel you really, like, this ain't what you want. Option number three, you're moved on to somebody new. Like, I mean, brand new. I mean, no recycled new. Like, you real new. And you're really, like, really wanting to see what can go down between you and this new partner. Like, you're into that, you know. That's what I'm getting. Like, you're trying to see about somebody else. And this person's trying to come back. And you're just not interested no more. But that's what I got for you. So, let's get some letters. Watch your ears, because I'm about to shake. This next person can work in radio, I'm hearing, or something about radio is big for them. Now, here's the deal, you all. You may not see any letters reminiscent or any names. However, though, if the message is resonating, the message is resonating. But let's see. We have the letter K. We got I, we got M. Somebody's name could be Kim, Kimberly. Even Kim as in, you know, male, K-E-M, Kim. We have the letter H. We have the letter C. We have the letter I. Michigan, somebody could be from Michigan. We have the letter W. We have the letter D. We have the letter Y. We have the letter E. We have the letter O. We have the letter D. D again. P. I'm hearing that name David again. We have the letter R. We have the letter G. We have the letter I. We have the letter R again. We have the letter T. We have the letter A. Somebody's name could be Gary here. We have the letter E. I know it's a Y over there, but y'all get what I'm trying to say. The letter U. We have the letter L. And we have the letter N. Somebody be a Mariah Carey fan even, this MC. But that's what I have for you, option number one. So let me know how this resonated in the comment section below. How did this resonate? Did it resonate? If you'd like to book a private reading, coaching, Sunday read, walking with your priority reading, I want you to check that pinned comment below as well as the description box below. Join me on my meet and greet tour, May 21st, I'm over here saying every day but the date, May 21st, that's a Saturday, 2022, there's two times that we can meet within May 21st for that meet and greet. People are already signed up, that's going to already show up, and I am super excited, and I want to see you too. So go to wineriesparrowtarot.com, go to meet and greet, and yeah, let's do it. And this is all I have for you all. So yeah, go follow me on my other YouTube channels. And I want you all to have a beautiful rest of day whenever you're watching this, or a beautiful sleep, because I know some of y'all be watching me right before bed and all that good stuff. So get you some rest. I love you all. Thank you all. And peace and blessings. Goodbye.